Earlier, we looked at a paper by Acemoglu, Johnson, and Robinson, who asked, what's the effect of having strong property rights on economic development? And in the data, we saw that countries with strong property rights tended to have higher economic development. But we noted that might not be a causal effect because of confounding variables and other things. So, in fact, in the paper, the authors write, to estimate the impact of institutions on economic performance, we need a source of exogenous variation in institutions. So what are they going to do? They're going to do an instrumental variables analysis. Now remember, the unit of analysis is countries. Their outcome variable is a measure of economic development, GDP per capita in the year 1995. Their treatment variable is a measure of property rights, the average protection against expropriation risk. So we need a third variable, the instrument, to do an instrumental variables analysis. What are they going to use? European settler mortality during the colonial era. So what do I mean exactly, and what's their idea? Well, in the years 1600 to 1800, European countries were sailing around the world and colonizing various parts of the world. Some of these places had more diseases and other things that made it a more hostile environment to live in. And so mortality was higher in these places. So in the places that had lower settler mortality, where it was more likely for the European settlers to stay alive, they were more likely to get permanent European establishments. And those places then imported institutions from Europe that protected property rights that then persisted to the year 1995. So that first argument suggests that the relevance assumption holds, that places with lower settler mortality in the colonial era, 1600 to 1800, actually imply that those countries have higher property rights in the year 1995. So the instrument, settler mortality, actually affects the treatment variable, property rights. That's the first assumption we needed. The second assumption is that settler mortality, the instrument, does not directly affect economic development in 1995, GDP. So that is plausible because you think that, well, although the institutions persisted over hundreds of years, GDP today probably doesn't depend directly on whether settlers were dying in the year 1600 or not. So finally, the third assumption they need is exogeneity. And they argue that this holds because the fact that some parts of the world had higher risk of disease and some parts of the world had lower risk is just unrelated to other factors that would affect GDP in the year 1995. So that suggests that the third assumption, exogeneity, holds. So with all of these assumptions, they can then proceed to do an instrumental variables analysis to learn about the effect of property rights on economic development. So before we go there, I'll just note that this paper is very well known and also is quite contentious. And that's pretty common with an instrumental variables analysis because, as we've talked about in another module, two of the three assumptions are unrefutable. You can't refute them with the data you have. You have to use other arguments to show that they hold. Another issue that arises here is how do we even measure the instrument? How do we measure settler mortality in the year 1600, 1700, or 1800? That was a long time ago. So there are issues with this analysis, but it's been very influential, and we'll put these issues aside and just see what they get. So the first thing, remember the main idea behind instrumental variables analysis is that we look at the correlation between the instrument and the outcome. And that correlation reflects the true causal effect of the treatment on the outcome. So here, on the horizontal axis, we've plotted the instrument, log settler mortality. So countries with higher mortality are over here, like Mali. Countries with lower settler mortality are over here, like Australia and the US. On the vertical axis, we've plotted our outcome variable, log GDP per capita in 1995. So countries down here, like Mali, have lower GDP per capita in 1995. Countries up here have higher GDP per capita in 1995, like Australia and the US. And you can see there is a correlation between these two variables. Countries that have lower mortality tended to have higher GDP in 1995. And remember, this is a variable that's measured in the year 1600 to 1800. This is a variable that's measured in the year 1995. So, assuming that this instrumental variable satisfies those three assumptions, we know that this correlation here reflects the true causal effect of property rights on economic development. So in the next module, we'll see how they compute that exact effect by using two-stage least squares.